me give you a hand. I have an extra I'm not using. Won't you let me lighten your load? I mean, after all, your legs are shaking, and I can understand. All I need is your hand. Oh, won't you take the fall? It is me after all. Won't you let me match your stride? I can slow it down if you want to. We can handle it side by side.
Okay, I have to turn the music off, I'm an idiot. Alright, hello everyone, welcome back to the DMPGL Grand Final. This is game 4 of a best of 5 between Team Titan, a Malaysian team, and First Departure from Singapore. Currently the score is 2-1, going the way of Titan. Thank you of course to the sponsors of this tournament, BenQ, Western Digital, Gigabyte themselves, and TotaTalk for allowing me, Lily, and my co-caster here, the Evil Twig, to cast this game. Hello.
I want to see another game like that last one.
That was great.
I don't know what this game is going to entail to be better than game number 2. Honestly. The Ancient was on 250 HP, and Hana missed the hook. Oh no! And the Timbersaw just got back. I reckon Timbersaw could have even suicided to TP back with the Bloodstone charges that he had. But you know that requires a bit of creativity. 5 seconds man, remaining. Maybe an Aegis deny from KYXY.
Yeah, maybe. No. I think the Twitch chat would just die if we did that, or if KYXY did that. But it would definitely make that game as exciting as last one. That was insane. I was laughing my head off. As everyone heard, I apologize for that. I know I cackle like a witch. But, God, that was classic. But I'm... First Departure, I don't know. I think they're going to put maybe mid or feed in mid this game. I was talking to Lubby during the break. And for one, like you said, Hannah missing that clockwork hook, they're all very cranky ass on a scale of 1 to 10. How annoyed First Departure are at Hannah for missing their cook. Clockwork hook, and Lubby said 11, so they're off the scale with anger. But wow, OD pick up. Oh, that's so sneaky. How did First Departure not catch that? But anyway, mid or feed, probably gonna go beat this game. Banning out the Razor. I mean, like, how did First Departure not go, oh, they obviously want the OD? But I guess if they banned out the OD, Batrider would still be in the pool. So by banning out the Visage, it leaves the OD and the Batrider in the pool. So now First Departure can pick up that Batrider if they want.
They can pick up the Batrider. A lot of heroes have been kind of developing slowly to deal with the Outward Devourer, one of which is Troll. Another is the Conker. So there are a couple of other options. And you know, you could always just run a normal mid hero and then just gank the crap out of the Outward Devourer if you really want to. But you know, we'll kind of have to see what they want to do for First Departure. I know they like to have a lot of farm on Miracle, and they like to give him a free lane and pretty much ensure that he never dies and gets 10 last hits a minute. And we saw that last game, just farming like an absolute monster. Even though his team was under so much pressure, he even smoked out and almost won the game pretty much single-handedly by himself. First Departure taking a while to think of the next picks. They're probably just talking about the Batrider and what that pick actually ensues. And Batrider and Chen, so two potential junglers, maybe a mid Batrider or solo safe or solo offlane Batrider.
Yeah, I'm thinking maybe Hana's going to pick up the Batrider and go into the jungle / offlane area. I mean, like I said, typically Hana does play the initiation type hero. You know, with the clockwork we saw last game going in the mid lane, normally heroes like the Lifestealer who can just run forward and grab onto someone, or Batrider kind of fits into that role as an initiation style hero. So I feel like Hana might be playing the Batrider, but of course we might see Polson pick it up and actually go mid this game. But I don't really think that they can put Batrider mid against an OD, because an OD will just destroy him completely. So maybe you're going to see something like a pickup of a Kunkka, even a Silibear maybe to go mid. Viper's another possibility, though it's a bit iffy against that OD. But I think a Kunkka would go nicely.
I'd love to see a Silibear for First Departure. That'd be amazing. Well, they have the chin already, and as I said before, you know, the ganking is a way to deal with the Outward Devourer. After he's used his astral imprisonment, there's not really much, many ways I should say, to escape from enemy heroes. And if you have creeps that can't get astral imprisoned, like a centaur or a dark troll warlord, you know, you're not going to get away from that. So I think First Departure, they have an idea in mind and what they're going to do to deal with this Outward Devourer. They're not just going for a direct kind of pick, they're going for strategy, they're going for tactics, and lifesteal are getting picked up by Titan. And we haven't actually talked about the bans yet, so Naga, Razor was you mentioned before, but an anti-mage banned by Titan, so they're worried about the split push from First Departure, and I can completely understand that. Darkseer, Visage, and Nyx Assassin being banned from First Departure, and we'll see the fourth ban coming out here from Titan. Maybe another split pusher.
Yeah, maybe something. Probably not the Phantom Lancer. Miracle doesn't really play him as much. But definitely. Well, Miracle, honestly, we've seen he can turn any hero into a split pusher if he wants to. So I don't really know if they can ban it out. But the Naga ban, I'm very disappointed. I really want to see Miracle play Weaver. I mean, not Weaver, Naga Siren. If you've seen Weaver. Oh my god, I'm just saying Weaver now. Stop it, Lily. Miracle play Naga Siren. It is just. He's just insane. Like, he will be farming 7 camps at once using the illusions and the manta. And banning out the Timbersaw, actually. Team pick. So I don't know, I think they're going to be bringing the A game, because first of all, you know, if they lose one more game, they're out. They're going to, you know, Titans are going to take this, so they must be thinking very, very carefully about this.
What's to say that Titan won't pick up another Ursa?
Well, I guess that'd be a completely greedy lineup, but they could, I guess.
But
they've got the Batrider now. Like, last game, as I was saying, they had nothing to do with the Ursa. They had Rubik Lift, and that was about it. But now they've got a Batrider, so even if, you know, Ursa goes for a BKB, that Batrider's just going to initiate him every time. And if Ursa can't be hitting, he's not that good.
The Lesser was such a strong ability. Going through BKB, as you said, last game they needed the Lifestealer to get an Abyssal Blade on First Departure's team, and they just couldn't get the farm on him. Like, understandably, an offlane Lifestealer not going to get an Abyssal Blade anytime soon, but the Troll Warlord picked up by First Departure, so this is another aggressive hero, kind of early aggression, with nuke damage, maybe, probably not a split pusher, maybe a mid hero.
Yeah, I think Troll Warlord, actually no, Troll Warlord can beat mid, I forgot about this, but Troll Warlord is one of those heroes that can actually beat an OD in the mid lane. He's got really nice damage with his Berserker's Rage, and he can harass that OD fantastically using his Whirling Axes. I've seen Troll Warlords beat the OD in mid lane, so that's probably going to be the mid lane of the First Departure being played by Pulson, I would assume. Since he did play the Troll Warlord in the first game, I think he would be comfortable with that hero. But, I mean, I don't know, Titan's lineup, this is a little bit less aggressive than we saw coming out from them the past two games. I mean, Lifestealer is aggressive, but OD usually needs a little bit more farm, especially because I don't know if he's going to... Well, okay, there's a Crystal Maiden pickup. Never mind, that's aggression coming out from then. Lifestealer, Crystal Maiden, that's very easy kills. As long as the Crystal Maiden can position herself well enough that she's not going to get picked up by that Troll Warlord or the Batrider, she's going to help out getting a lot of kills.
I have to say, I'm a little bit surprised about the Crystal Maiden pickup. I think maybe a Keeper of the Light could have been a little bit better, so to speak, just because it has that anti-push. You have the ability to recall, and they've already found out that First Departure love to play that split push kind of game style. And if you have a Keeper of the Light with the recall ability, you can have one of your carriers TP back, take all the farm that's coming in from the split push, which is usually a big creep wave, and then recall back into the fight and go for a push before the split push actually has any impact. But Crystal Maiden being picked and Windrunner immediately picked by First Departure.
So like I said, random pickups. Windrunner could be played as a support, or we could be seeing Miracle run that as a carry. First Departure just lacking on the team fight. They just seem to like pickups. They don't like team fighting, apparently. I mean, the past two games have had this as well, where they just have had heroes that just don't team fight well. And it looks like this is going to be another game where that happens. And with the Troll Warlord, if they do decide to go for a bit more of a split-pushing lineup, he does fit quite well into that, as, you know, in the 4 rather than the 1, just because he's got the Global Ultimate. So he can just cast that Battle Trance and, you know, whatever the carry is can just whack, 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 whack. But man, now with the Abaddon pickup from Titan, First Departure is not going to be able to teamfight this at all. If they try, they're going to be in a lot of trouble.
The Aphotic Shield, I believe that's what it's called. Yeah, the Aphotic Shield stops the Batrider lasso. And that in itself
10
makes him
seconds
invaluable. If he gets if he sits at the back of the fight and chucks a shield on
remaining. 5
somebody who gets
seconds
lassoed,
remaining.
and then that ability, the Blink Dagger, pretty much going to waste, it means that Batrider will be sitting in
10
the middle of a
seconds
whole bunch of
remaining.
heroes for the Titan squad, being like, sweet, you just blinked into our team, we'll kill you now.
Yeah.
And I don't know, really, really, really strong pickup, really strong draft here from Titan. I like First Departure's draft as well, but I'm just
Dire
really
Doom
curious to
Bolt.
know what they're going to do with it and how they're going to land it as well.
Yeah, I mean, looking at it at the moment, I would say Batrider in the jungle slash offlane, Chen in the jungle, Windrunner support, Troll Ward mid. That would be my guess looking at the
10
lineup
seconds
thus far, but it's all
remaining.
going to depend on their last pick. Titan is very cut and dry. OD, mid
5
lane,
seconds
Lifesteal, Crystal
remaining.
Maiden, Abaddon. Possibly going to be an aggressive tri lane, but more likely passive. Darkseer
Azir
has
is
been banned out
dying.
finally, so not going to be seeing a Winter Darkseer for the first time the whole night. I
5
wonder if he can play
seconds
anything else.
remaining.
But, oh well, Wolfling banned out.
Radiant team pick.
But, you know, probably some other AoE hero to go on the off lane. Elder Titan hasn't been banned out yet, so we might be seeing a pickup from that. Even something like a Magnus or a Tidehunter, just some kind of AoE to help out in the team fights. That seems to be what Winter's role is, just going for kind of a utility off laner with AoE.
Morphling could have been amazing. Imagine that first
10
game,
seconds remaining.
but First Departure actually were ahead in the early game. Imagine that. Because Outward Devourer
5
doesn't put
seconds
pressure on,
remaining.
he only puts pressure on the mid lane, and that's about it. And all they would have to deal with would be an
Reserve
offlane
time.
hero. Maybe Titan looking to do an aggressive tri lane of such a greedy hero such as the Morphling would actually be picked. Gyrocopter could be a good choice, but you know, if they pick up an Alchemist, then Titan, by all means, they could just go ahead and kill First Departure the first maybe 10 minutes in the game.
Yeah, definitely. They've got a much better kind of level one lineup, I guess, just with the damage coming out from the Lifesteal, the Crystal Maiden, the Abaddon Shield. But First Departure's lineup, it really looks like they're just going for a four
Medusa.
protect one. Wow.
Yes, Medusa.
Dire team pick.
Oh yes.
I have not seen Troll Ward and Medusa before, but I can imagine this is gonna work miracles. But just with that aura and the switch shot damage. Yeah, you just laugh. Just pretend like I'm funny. The Troll Warlord aura, as well as his battle trance and the split shot damage, is just going to be huge. Especially if she goes for something like a Blink Dagger. She
10
probably won't,
seconds
but you know,
remaining.
assuming she did go for something crazy and you know, catching four or five heroes
5
in
seconds remaining.
the Stone Gaze, that could potentially, you know, be a team down. But we're gonna
Mirana.
have to see. Anyway, Mirana pick up last, so I was wrong completely. They don't want team fight. They want arrows in the face.
Arrows in the face, indeed. I think that Mirana, always a good pick off, pick, always a good pick if you know that your enemy are running potentially a safe lane farming hero with the jungler. You can do an aggressive tri lane with the Crystal Maiden, Abaddon, and Mirana. And if anybody gets caught out at all, that frostbite into the arrow, that is one dead hero straight away. And if they try and counter initiate, you've got the Aphotic Shield, you've got the heals coming out from the mist coil, and that's how do you deal with that? And then you've got a solo safe lane farming Lifestealer and KYXY who also has to be dealt with. So if
10
any of these
seconds
heroes
remaining.
don't get dealt with, they're gonna snowball and become huge.
I
5
don't know if
seconds remaining.
they're gonna be running a solo safe lane Lifestealer, if they're gonna do a jungle Lifestealer. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, every game I've seen Titan play, they've done
Prepare
a
for battle.
passive tri lane. But I guess we'll see. Anyway, let's go through the players. On the side of First Departure, we have got Miracle the Man playing the Medusa. Hana is going to be on that Batrider. Looks like he's going to be straight into the jungle. He's just getting rid of all the camps here, so no worries for him. Troll Warlord is going to be played by Polson, aka Mid or Feed. Lubby is going to be playing that Windrunner, and Chen is going to be played by Mean.
And for Titan, we have Extinct sitting on the Abaddon down the bot lane. KYXY, we have sitting on Outward Devourer up above him. Ohio, Priestess of the Moon, Mirana, Net on the Crystal Maiden, and going towards maybe a little bit more to the mid lane, Lifestealer. on Endless Winter. So not Endless Winter, Winter.
Endless Winter.
Man, yeah, he it's wishes. Been a long day. It's,
you know, it's all right, it's all right.
It's 4 a.m. in the 4 a.m. in the morning.
Yeah, no, that's right. God, thank you for casting with me then. I'm losing my voice, but you've been casting all day because you've been doing Tides of Wrath, haven't you?
Indeed. Yeah.
Yeah. Poor you.
It's fantastic. Great yeah. Dota games all day.
Well, it looks like they are going to be running a solo safe lane Lifestealer. And Miracle... What are you doing, Miracle?
The battle Miracle begins. Is ancienting. Quelling Blade is coming in.
Seriously? What the hell? No, like...
You can do it. You just got to chop down a specific...
Oh, no, I know. You cut down these trees here. You cut down these ones. And you can get rid of these ones as well. I ancient Medusa all the time. But... When they've got so much riding on this match.
Well, I mean, they thought exactly what I thought. Titan,
running
you know, they have Priestess of the Moon. Of course, like, this is such a strong, aggressive tri lane. If you do defensive, it's pretty much wasting the lane.
But
and so,
yeah.
Miracle, realizing this, saying, you know, this tri lane's too strong. I'm not going to get anything in this lane. I'm just going to die and feed. And so they put the Windrunner down there solo instead, and now they have three solo lanes and two junglers. This is greedy... as anything.
Yeah, this is crazy greedy. And is it going to work out? That's the question. And I mean, Medusa can ancient stack and farm incredibly well. I mean, she can get better farm, honestly, at the ancients and in lane if she can do it right and doesn't get contested. But this is just... I mean, as soon as Titan catch on to this, they're just going to be stopping her? Like, what?
It's a long way away, though. Like, the supports will have to run all the way up to the ancients, and even then they're not secure to kill. Crystal Maiden only has 280 movement speed, the slowest support in the game. And Abaddon, what does he have to deal with that? He has the Aphotic Shield. Maybe he can mess up a few stacks, but he's not going to be able to kill the Medusa.
I guess. Oh well. Better probably to watch the other lane. So, Ohio on bot lane. Like you mentioned, they're running that aggressive tri lane. It is very, very deadly. Frostbite into Arrow will be enough to kill anyone, and they've got the ability to dive quite aggressively with the LOA shield. The LOA! Look at him! Stealing those ancients! Exactly what I said, what I thought he would do.
Oh, wow. Actually, gets one of the last hits. Well played there by Extinct. Actually, gets his self popped by Chen.
He's going to be forced back. You can't quite go too aggressively until he hits level 6 and gets that regeneration up. But on bot lane, Lubby, honestly, I give the advantage in this lane to the Windrunner in a one-on-one situation. The only downside is that Ohio has been not pulled, but he's got a lot more items up. But, I mean, base damage and attack animation, Windrunner should beat a Priestess of the Moon. Priestess of the Moon has got terrible attack damage and terrible attack animation. I mean, it's not terrible, but it's not great. Actually, on top lane, we see first blood on Hannah. We are.
Oh, first blood on Hannah.
Oh!
Flies completely off the map. It's 50 HP and Net and Extinct just getting their hopes up for nothing. Getting teased a little by this Batrider. No reason left.
My boyfriend's making fun of me. Well, he just fell off his chair, so whatever. That's what he gets for making fun of me. I'm sorry, I just get excited by Dota. And I make stupid noises. Anyway, yeah, that was a really close call on Hannah. And the problem with having a Chen and a Batrider means that he can't rotate into the jungle. But I mean, in mid lane, Trollwater doing decently, 10 to 7 versus 13 to 8, so he's having a nice time against that. Ohio, though, is actually completely dominating Lubby. Lubby's on 3 to 0, so he's not doing so good, but that's really good for the Priestess of the Moon. If he can get up a fast, maybe Phase Boots, he'll be, you know, smoking, running around the map, helping out ganking, and. I mean, in this kind of a lineup, with this Medusa pickup, First Departure is just so greedy. And they really need to get the farm on Miracle, and Titan are just going to punish that. With a Lifestealer, with the Priestess of the Moon, and with an OD versus a Medusa, I mean, with this Tri-Core coming out from Titan, they should really be able to just kind of win the game by about 25 minutes like we've been seeing.
This is such a strange way to lane this. Miracle has actually rotated back bottom. He's realized that, you know, I'm not actually getting enough in this Ancients. It's kind of been contested a little. Lubby wasn't really winning bot lane anyway, so now going bot with the Quelling Blade.
He can farm now, easy.
He's got that plus 12% damage.
Yeah.
OP.
Yeah.
And Lubby contesting farm as well.
Haste.
Mid lane, middle feed, actually doing a really good job. Has 7 denies to an OD. Getting denies. Oh, KY, XY, are you gonna. No. 80 HP. Backs off to base. So, mid. This mid lane's kind of been one bottle charge, full mana. So, this. As soon as these intelligence steals, as soon as the astral imprisonment is gone, it's gonna be a full mana troll warlord. And that's only one bottle charge.
Yeah, and I mean that's the one good thing about versing an OD in lane. If you get a bottle, as soon as when he's on 52 mana, like you just said, one bottle charge, he's full mana, and then as soon as those stacks wear off, he's back to full mana. Now he's down to 13 mana, so no more mana for him, but he doesn't really care. But Ohio actually having such a good time on bot lane. 31 CS, 7 denies, boots up, bottle up, and top lane is actually probably going to fall as well. They've rotated the tri lane up there, they know Ohio doesn't need any help. Hannah being forced out of lane, can't go to the jungle to farm. And yeah, his laning phase is not going very good for First Departure.
The most important thing for them is to maybe get a couple of core items on some of the heroes, but who's going to get the core items? You've got a mid lane, which is kind of shaky. It's an OD. They haven't been able to gank the OD. They've just been forced to farm. Windrunner, she's going for a soul ring, so we're not going to see anything like a mechanism or anything coming out from Windrunner. What is Medusa going to need? Maybe upped boots, phase boots, treads? But that's not a big item like a Lincoln Sphere that... you need these items. You need a Blink Dagger and Batrider, but it's going to be way late. These timings are completely off.
Yeah, no, this Medusa probably is not going to get very much. I mean, it's going to turn to the point where First Departure are going to be forced to give absolutely everything to the Medusa. I mean, when you pick a Medusa, she's not picked too much in competitive play, but normally you pick her when you can have absolutely dominating lanes. But they've really been outlaned very, very hard by Titan. And the heroes just don't have catch-up mechanisms. I mean, maybe I'm being too mean to First Departure's draft, but what can the heroes do to catch up? On CS, they're completely getting smashed. Priestess of the Moon is... Sorry, Morana is...
Lobby, are you going to take a fall? The shackle goes down, the arrow... That's the last hit. The arrow actually lands on Miracle. Is he going to turn around? No, he just runs away. It was ours. First Blood going the way of Ohio. So this is more gold towards her. She has... treads up and 900 gold. This is her Aquila if she wants it. The one thing that First Departure are doing right now is they're actually stacking the Ancients, which always that little bit extra gold injection into the carry. If she's able to get some way to take this down without dying, that's the main important thing. You don't devour. Completely missed that. Getting a kill on the Troll Warlord.
Yeah, he just dropped his ult down to get the last hit. Net rotating in. Trying to help out, didn't manage to do anything much, but he was there in moral support.
Net, getting some experience, level 4 now. And so is Ebon, so the levels of the support's doing quite well compared to the Chen. Actually, First Departure are doing okay as well. The main concern is the fact that Morana, level 8, Lifestealer, level 7, and Outward Devourer, level 7 as well. These levels are just getting out of hand completely for Titan.
Titan have really done a fantastic job. I mean, the wards they did to block the camps out, they blocked this one, and this one, if I recall correctly. I think they pretty much blocked everything down here. So Chen was forced to farm between these two camps. He's still in level 3. Actually, on top lane, no, they're not going to see a kill. And Batrider, that means Batrider couldn't rotate into the jungle. And Titan are just doing everything right this game. They're really playing amazingly. And recently... I'm going to be honest, they have not been performing, but today, they've just been, they're just showing why they came third in the International 3. With Mushy, yes, it's been a different lineup, but, Radiant's bottom tower. I mean, they're just showing why they're a very strong team. They've really got it together.
You've got to play well when it counts.
Yeah, oh god, on bot lane, Lubby.
Bot lane, Lubby gets arrowed in the face. The frostbite goes down as well. Morana gets the last hits. This is 2-0 for Morana. 64 last hits. Only 9 minutes in. 65, and that's all of those cleaned up as well. Maybe even a tower kill going her way. Ohio is going to be huge. And last hit. Nice work. So that's 1.5k gold in advantage. I mean, just for the Morana, but... Oh, Extinct. Going on Hana. Hana gets Astral imprisoned. The shackle Doesn't latch. Extinct. Running away. Is he gonna get away? 15 HP. KYXY got his back, and the Moonlight Shadow just stopping that initiation.
Beautiful Moonlight Shadow coming out. No follow-up power shot from Lobby getting that last hit, and that could have been a really nice kill for First Departure. They need something. I mean, they need anything at the moment. A kill, a tower, something to get them back actually on top lane.
Middle feed, getting initiated on, but Hana's there to say hi. No, he hasn't leveled Lasso yet. Oh, there you go, there's Lasso, so... If he did have that Lasso, maybe it would be a dead Endless Winter, but he does have Infest.
Endless Winter.
920... I've been casting the wrong scene this whole time, but Lifestealer.
Yeah, just Winter or just Lifestealer, whatever, it doesn't matter.
Winter. He did have Infest, he did have almost 1000 HP. He's not gonna die just to that. Unless you get a lucky bash, like on the very last hit after the last two finishes, but you know, I'm not gonna bet my rares on that.
Oh. Well, these people who bet rares on First Departure must be feeling pretty sad at the moment. No, I'm kidding. First Departure, still in it to win it. I mean, if they can total for the next 40 minutes or so, Priestess of the Moon can't out-carry a Medusa in most situations. Though, I have to say, I do like this Priestess of the Moon pickup because she's a really good defusal carrier. And Lubby, oh god, Lubby.
Lubby, what's going on here?
He's rotating in,
looking for a kill, but... Lubby, one level of Windrun, does have 3 levels of Power Shot, 2 levels of Shackle. If she does get that Shackle Shot, it will be a dead hero. Ohio, seeing Hana, the Lasso is up. I don't know why he didn't turn on that. I guess because Abaddon was just behind waiting for the Lasso to come out. Just chuck the shield on and bye-bye Lasso. Wasted spell. Really well played here by Titan. Just positionally, just really nice. Miracle trying to find some farm. Going for an early drama, actually.
Might be seeing a fight down on bot lane. Hana, is he a Lubby? Is he to join the party too?
The Shackle goes out. Extinct. Getting Shackled, but nothing happens about it. You can't lasso the Murana because then the shield will come out immediately. Turn rate's being slowed. Bit of a nuisance, but they're just backing off. All five heroes are just caving in.
I mean,
just
they're
waiting.
They've got five here, so they really kind of have to make something happen, because meanwhile, Winter is just farming. He's got his armor lot up, he's got his phase boots, he's happy as Larry. In mid lane, KYXY picked up a 4-star. And Departure, look at Ohio, there's five heroes down here, and Ohio's still
just
playing like crazy.
Oh, the Shackle goes on Ohio. Is he going to take a fall here? The shield's probably going to go on him. The Mist Coil goes, but the Moonlight Shadow, is there any detection? There's no detection!
Oh, yes there is!
Oh, Sentry just flies out, and Ohio realizes this. They turn around, and the Shackle misses completely. Shield going on Ohio. Lifestealer running in. Gonna get Miracle on the back of the fight. The Wild Wing Ripper using the Tornado, but then the Saturday's Eclipse double kill for KYXY. And meanwhile, Lubby getting a kill on Abaddon by herself. Ohio saying, more kills for me.
It's a 4-for-1 exchange, though.
That was a messy fight.
But that was a fight that went completely in Titan's favor. They had everything to lose there, but... I mean, First Departure were just way too scared to go in. They felt like they couldn't win a team fight. I mean... Hana can't get close enough. He doesn't have a blink up yet. 13 minutes into the game. He's maybe halfway to a blink at the moment. And... I don't know, they're really just everything is going to have to go into this Medusa. I mean, I think that the whole lineup now is just going to be everyone walk behind Medusa and watch him farm. Because if they go alone, they're just going to lose the team fights. OD is pretty fat for this stage of the game. I mean, looking at the net worth, 6,500, 6,300, 5,500, and the Medusa on 3,000. I mean, she is 2,000-3,000 behind the cores on the side of Titan.
Oh, there's an initiation. Arrow misses completely. Net uses Frostbite on middle feed, but Lubby taking a fall, uses the Windrun, TP's out, but doesn't get out at the very last minute. Takes a fall to Lifestealer. Extinct. Net getting killed by the creeps, and the Lasso finally being used. Hasn't been cancelled this one time. Chin taking a fall. Winter. He gets the shield on him. Is he going to be able to turn around? Maybe hit some things, get his health back. The Mist Coil getting used on him. He's out of HP. He has the armlet. He procs it. He gets out with 1 HP. And now KYXY turns around, comes in from the side, and gets a kill on the Lifestealer. Oh, KYXY, no. That was completely wrong. Hana taking a fall to Ahio. Middle feed. Are you going to get away? The Astral Imprisonment's still up. Extinct's getting away with low HP. Everyone kind of getting away. But there you go. Trouble or taking a fall. How did Lifestealer die?
I think it was... what is it? Kaidu the Catapult? Because there was a catapult standing right here. He armlet toggled. There was no other heroes around him. The heroes were all down here. Lifestealer was up here. And then he died.
Oh...
I think the catapult walked up and
hit him. I was so confused. I see KYXY coming in. I'm like, wait a minute, he's on the same team.
Yeah, I don't know, but man, first departure. What is going on with him today? I'm looking at the gold graph, about 10,000 in favor of Titan experience, over 10,000, 12,000. And first departure, they're really just relying on Medusa. And Titan are just punishing that. I mean, I guess Titan have really realized that first departure kind of just play for Miracle. That's what they do. They put everything into Miracle and Miracle carries them. Not to say the other players don't have their worth, but that's kind of their thing. Miracle does everything. And Titan have just decided, hey, you know, we'll punish Miracle. We won't let Miracle get her farm up, or his farm up. And it's working a charm. Those Tricores are completely dominating. And yeah, sure, if they got to the really late game, first departure could turn this around and win, but Titan aren't going to let them get to that point. Probably going to see them go for a Roshan attempt in the not too distant future and just finish the game.
Ohio, you're going to get a kill here. The Infest comes out. Lobby just gets absolutely demolished. But who is this here? Oh, the Troll Warlord getting frostbited, getting arrowed, and double kill for Lifestealers. More farm going the way of Winter. More staff and a Mystic staff as well on the Outward Devourer on KYXY. Maybe you're going to see some action in middle. Chin, only level 6 though. Only got 3 levels of that Holy Persuasion, so only 2 creeps. Quite a big deal.
Well, I mean, all the wards in the jungle really shut him down, and now when, you know, the wards are dead, he can't go into the jungle because they've been fighting there constantly, and Titan are just dominating every team fight. Lobby can't do anything, he's just dying, and even his Ursas, I mean, he'd probably be better at this point if he went and, you know, grabbed creeps that had auras. Those auras would be a lot more helpful, maybe like the Wildkin for the armor aura, or even the regeneration aura, unholy aura from the Scytia creeps, because those, the Ursas just can't get in. The Ursas just get dropped down so quickly by the OD.
My favorite creep is probably the Coblod creep, the one that gives you extra movement speed. The speed aura, 12%, that is so good. The Kobold Foreman. There you go, there's one there. But it gets killed by the Batrider.
Batrider doesn't care.
No more Kobold.
And Medusa has got her Diffusal Blade up. I mean, I haven't had a look at the items anytime recently, but she's got the Diffusal Blade up. So like I was saying, Priestess of the Moon, Mirana, is a really good Diffusal Blade carrier. And that's the perfect counter to a hero like Medusa that relies on her mana to stay alive. So I mean... I mean, Titan are just playing so well. They're really just, I don't know. After watching them recently, they've been losing every game I've seen. So for them to win a game, winning first departure, they lost to like dismally yesterday. They absolutely got destroyed.
Oh, top lane. Are they in a good position here? Miracle, not probably in the best of places, but they can't really punish him for being up here unless the open wounds goes on him or Nip gets the frostbite. The frostbite goes on the Troll Warlord. Chin ulti, the Hand of God, and then the Priestess of the Moon ulti, the Moonlight Shadow. Big Shackle, Winter, turning around, getting kills, Outward Devourer, double, triple kill. And now, Chin takes a fall. No ultra kill going the way of KOXY. That looked like a fight for First Departure to win. That Shackle was so huge. Got both Outward Devourer and the Lifestealer, but it didn't work out for them.
Wow. So Titan, top tower come on top of the GMPGL. 3, well, to essentially 0. I mean, First Departure got a 1 win advantage from being in the winner bracket. But Titan just said, no, you don't get anything today. And that was a 3-0. Wow. Well, GG, well played to both teams. Titan just played their hearts out today. They did amazing. Thank you, of course, to the sponsors, the GMPGL. Gigabyte, Western Digital, and BenQ. And thank you for co-casting with me. The Evil Twig will post something in the chat. I don't know what, but he'll post something. Any final words?
No, it was really fun today. Enjoyed casting. Casted for maybe, it would have been 8-9 hours today. And now it's 4:07 in the morning. Probably going to get some shut-eye, maybe do some casting tomorrow. I know that I'm doing casting for another tournament. And hopefully that goes well. Thanks for having me today.
Well, yes. Thanks for casting. Thanks for watching, guys. See you later.